Hey everybody, it's Dan Malloy, and I'm doing this because we've been getting some great questions on Facebook and on Twitter, and so I thought I'd take a few minutes and answer some of the questions that have come in. Craig sent in a question. What is your position on state employees and possible concessions? Well, number one, I want to thank state employees for doing their job. Most state employees are hardworking, diligent folks. And to the extent that there are individuals who aren't working as hard as they should, you know, it's my job as the governor, the top manager of the state, to make sure we maximize efficiencies across all employee classes. But I want to work with them as a partner, as a fellow state employee. You asked about possible concessions. You know, I've made it very clear. We have a $3.4 billion problem staring us in the face starting next July 1. And if I'm elected on November 2nd, I start that work November 3rd of planning a budget that begins the process of fully balancing the budget. I've got to get that done. I've talked about the requirement of going to GAAP, generally accepted accounting principles, as the way that will structurally make change. We've got to be telling ourselves the truth between the legislature, the governor, and all of the departments and agencies. Secondly, we have to bring everyone to the table. There are a lot of good ideas out there. State employees know how to save money. They've been bringing a list to the current governor saying, do this or this or this to save money. And you know what? They've been held off and no one's listened. So we'll begin by listening November 3rd, getting those best ideas and implementing those. And then finally, asked about concessions. You know, I'm not negotiating as a candidate, but what I've said clearly is everyone's invited to the table. Everyone will be treated with respect. We've got to put this state budget in order. We've got to close this gap, and I think state employees will help us in playing a role. Sue asked, what would you do differently as governor to make sure that some people's increased good fortune did not adversely affect others? Well, this is kind of a philosophical question. I frequently say that I want to run a Connecticut where a rising tide does raise all boats. The idea that one class or one group of people's interests should be put above another just doesn't fly with me. That's why I frequently talk about working class values and middle class values. And that's why I want to support the people who really make Connecticut strong. Sure, we have wealthy people, and in some senses our state leads that. But the difference between the wealthiest individuals in our state and the working class people is so wide that we've got to turn our economy around. We've got to bring jobs. We've got to make our cities safer and more attractive for job creation. Finally, Scott asked, Dan, will you be focusing on energy efficiency and green collar jobs that are supported by CEEF here in Connecticut? Absolutely. You know, I was mayor of Stamford for 14 years and very proud of the work that we did on climate change and energy efficiency. It all began when Al Gore called me back in 1997 and asked me to go to a conference on climate change. And when I went, before I went, I have to tell you, I was not a big convert to climate change. Not that I disagreed with it, but it just wasn't a thing that I thought about a lot. And that two-day conference changed my approach to energy efficiency and climate change. I became somebody who not consumed, but worked hard on those issues. That's why in Stamford we have decreased our particulate emissions by tens of thousands of tons. That's why a Clean Air, Cool Planet recognized Stamford over 6 years ago as the only municipality that year that they recognized and gave an award to. Even our own Governor Rell, who happens to be a Republican, recognized my efforts and that of Stamford just a couple of years ago on energy efficiency and climate change. And I'll tell you a few other things. A number of years ago, well over 10 years ago, we were the first city in the state to hire an engineer whose specific job it was to create energy efficiency and to limit particulate emissions as a contributor to climate change in the United States and the world. Will we focus on green jobs? Of course we're going to focus on green jobs. And there are lots of different kinds of green jobs. Any, you know, putting in new windows in the house that are better at insulating the house is a green job. Changing over lighting fixtures is a green job. Writing great computer programs that make it easier to make buildings more efficient is a green job. And producing products that themselves are green is a green job. Here we are in Connecticut with at least 20% of all of the people in the world who are working on fuel cell technology working in this one state. That's a particular area that I want to support because it's good for the environment. It's a cleaner way of generating electricity, and in Connecticut it will also generate jobs. So what we're going to have to do if I become governor is to figure out where we invest in areas that A, benefit our economy, benefit our environment, and also produce jobs in Connecticut. That'll be my focus. I'm Dan Malloy, and I approve this message.